hundreds of miles off the coast of Mumbai. India's embarking on a national first.
Offshore removal is a very challenging activity.
Dismantling five aging gas platforms.
Each platform has its own unique danger, just waiting for you.
All the platforms must be removed before the monsoon season hits, making this engineering feat a race against time. Over 25 years, the Tapti platforms have extracted almost 1.3 trillion cubic feet of gas from the Tapti gas field. Its primary purpose, to provide energy security for India, supplying at its peak approximately 15% of the country's gas. In 2016, after a decline in production, operations ceased. The challenge now is safely removing all five platforms and restoring the area to its original state.
This project is a milestone for India, setting a new standard for offshore decommissioning.
Before removal starts, partners Shell, Reliance and ONGC work with government to develop the decommissioning framework and agree the best plan with Indian contractors.
The decommissioning parameters are extremely strict. We do it safely, respect the environment while setting a national standard. We wanted to ensure the decommissioning process was as sustainable as possible.
Ultimate responsibility for the strict execution lies with contractors, L&T.
Decommissioning is a complex reverse engineering process that demands meticulous planning and precise execution.
First, the five platforms called topsides must be cut from their legs and each lifted by a giant 3,000-ton crane. Next, the four legs called jackets will be removed. Finally, topsides and jackets must be transported 253 miles for dismantling onshore.
This gas field is a very notorious for its high currents. Uncertainty needs to be anticipated.
Alongside the high currents, the greatest challenge is the weather. Each platform has to be removed before the monsoon season hits, when storms will make dismantling too dangerous. On a tight schedule, engineers first construct scaffolding around the topsides.
We have to build a scaffolding structure to access the cut location.
Once the scaffolding is in place, cutting can begin.
All preparations have been done, all checks have been completed.
Okay, everybody, go or no go?
Go!
We are good to go.
Cutting lasts for 6 hours. Only then are the team ready to attempt a delicate lift.
Okay, Rocky.
Okay, just even us up.
Okay, man, okay. Swinging left.
We just lifted almost 900 tons of steel.
Okay, all stop on the block. Okay, touchdown.
We got it set on this material barge. Now I've got my team there doing all the welding.
Okay, all stop there.
Bracing, getting the stability right so we can send this into the shore so they can take it apart.
Nice work, everybody.
With the topsides gone, the team prepares for their next challenge. Cutting and removing the jacket. They'll be cut from inside the legs, 5 meters below the seabed. But when Tapti was constructed, the legs were hammered into the seabed for stability and are now filled with soil.
The soil has been compacted within the legs for decades.
If they can't cut the legs from the inside, the team must resort to using divers to cut from the outside. But diving here presents its own unique challenges.
So in Tapti, diving is really difficult because they've got such high currents. There's a lot of sediment in the water. You can't see in front of the visor. So the divers need to feel their way around.
Thankfully, the team has a solution. A giant high-pressure hose to remove the soil one leg at a time.
Once we do that, then we're ready to go for the cutting.
A high-precision cutting tool is lowered into the legs. Using a mixture of high-pressure water and abrasive, it slices the steel from inside. With the legs cut, Tapti's jackets are ready for lifting.
Okay, let me know when you've got it connected and secure on your deck.
Roger, roger.
After 25 years underwater, the first jacket is safely lifted into the sunlight. Incredibly, after a million man hours, all five Tapti platforms are safely removed and shipped back to shore for recycling. Ahead of schedule and before the monsoon strikes. Mission accomplished. A new national benchmark set.
To be leading the team in India is one of the highlights of my career.
I'm truly proud to be part of this transformative journey.